आदिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय ओम श्रीभ्यो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपद्मवैतत्त्वज्ञानप्रत्यगत्वमेवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूमिवसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथासि शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथासि पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वातिकारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं सन्ततमोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणम् सूत्रभाष्यकृत वंदे भगवंत पुनः पुनः ईश्वर गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योम व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तुमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचर विचित्रतम प्रभावात् संसारधीजनित दुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मदीजनित सौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहं आशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजां कमलं सुखाकृतिम् So yeah, I wanted to check something. There's a part of it as well, but it doesn't make a difference. There is a samasta and a vyasta pada. So there was a question here as So manushya hamiti pratyaksha virodhena. So before that there was a nacha jeshta pratyaksha virodhad agama jnanasya badayati vachyam. Moving ahead of the class. I flipped the page. Okay, so here, for some reason the earlier page is not shown. What page is this? Just a second. 30. I forgot what it was. Does anyone remember? There was something that I wanted to confirm. Dehanya Atma Vada Prasanga. Yeah, here. Yeah. So, nacha jeshta pratyaksha virodhat agama jnanasya eva badayati vachyam dehatma vada prasangat. Yeah. So, dehatma vada prasangat, and when you flip the page, there was something that I wanted to. So, there is a continuation. So, there is a Purvapaksha here. You have to imagine a Purvapaksha here who has said jeshta pratyaksha virodhat agama jnanasya eva badha in the case of tattvamasi. So, in the case of Tattvamasi, Mahavakya, the Shruti counters the Anubhava. So, earlier he had said that there is no Bhana, Abhana Dva. So, there was a division made. Ki Madhyasasya Nastitvam Ayuktatvad Abhana Dva Karana Bhava Dva. So, if you say Ayuktatvad, that was countered by saying that, I mean, we have Ishtapati, we don't have any issue. Yes, it is illogical, but it is there. Anubhava Siddha. So if you say how is it Anubhava Siddha? Abhana Dva. Adhyasa is not known. There is no Anubhava Adhyasa. There Anubhava was shown by Kartaha Manushyomi and Ajnaha Karta and Manushyom. There the question is Ajna Karta Manushyom, if it is a Prama. Purvapakshi says it is a Prama. This is not a Brahma. This is not Adhyasa. Then the Siddhanti says that it is an Adhyasa because Shruti says that you are a Karta. You are Jnana Swarupa, you cannot be Ajnaha. You are Atma, which is Akarta, you cannot be Karta. And you are not limited to any human body or any body. All these are Upadis. You are Nasanga Atma, you cannot be Manushya. Therefore, this Anubhava of Ajnaha, Karta and Manushya, Aham, that is a Brahma. There, the Purvapakshi says that, na, not so. Why? Because he says jeshta pratyaksha. Pratyaksha is a jeshta pramana on which there is a dependency of shruti also. This much we have seen. Now in continuation, these Siddhantiya says you cannot say that. Why? Because dehatmavada prasanga. You will be reduced to a charvaka. So this you have to imagine a Purvapaksha as to how will I be reduced to a charvaka? I am not making a dehatmavada. How do you say so? So there the Siddhanti says manushyom iti pratyaksha virodhena athamayam ashariraha ityadi shrutiya deha anya atma asiddhe. So this asiddhe I wanted to check, but I found a patha as to dehad anya atma asiddhe. So whether it is dehad anya or deha anya, it is a panchami samasta or vibhakta pada. Now the Purvapakshi is saying that I do not agree with tattvamasi. So if you do not agree with tattvamasi, that is how he is countering that I do not agree with tattvamasi. There manushyaham iti pratyaksha virodhena. In that case, Siddhanti says, if you say that you are not a dehatmavadi, I'll tell you how you are a dehatmavadi, because manushyaham iti pratyaksha virodhena. In your case, when you say manushya, all darshanikas agree that they are not the sharira, but manushya is a deha sharira. And you will be saying that I am deha against countering the shruti as to the pratyaksha virodhena athayam ashariraha. The shruti says that you are ashariraha. So if you say only in the tattvamasi case I don't agree, then you are countering the shruti ashariraha also. Because pratyaksha cannot be a jeshta pramana only in the case of tattvamasi mahavakya. It will remain a jeshta pramana in your case for the athayam asharira also. Thereby you will become a sharira atma, deha atma vadi. So that is the that was the counter by the Siddhanti there. Now tika. Dehatma वाद प्रसंग देहात्मवाद प्रसंगाद इत्यर्थः बिकॉज यू लैंड इनटू देहात्मवाद इफ यू से सो तस्माद् सो व्हेन यू से तस्मादिदं सो इन रत्न प्रभा तस्मादिदं रजतम इतिवत सो व्हाट इज दी कंक्लूजन ऑफ दिस एनालिसिस हियर ऑफ अभानाद्वा. There is bhana, and that bhana, being anubhava siddha, it is there is bhana of adhyasa. If you say it is not adhyasa, it is prama, it is not brahma, it is prama, then you will become a dehatmavadi. Therefore what? Therefore, tasmad, dehatmavada prasangad. If you do not want to fall into dehatmavada prasanga, then you have to agree that it is a brahma. And thereby our example is what? Tasmad idam rajatam iti vatu. Just like this is a rajata in the case of shukti, there is a brahma that I am ajnaha karta manushya. This kind of bhana is a brahma, like the shukti being rajata is a brahma. Iti vat samanadikaranya pratyakshasya brahmatva shanka kalankitasya na agamat pravalyam iti asteyam. Therefore, the brahma that you have, just like idam rajatam, Idam Rajatam is also known Pratyakshataya. Because you say Idam, just like Ayam Loka Vyavahara. Naisariko Ayam Loka Vyavahara says Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Similarly, you are saying Idam Rajatam. That Idam Rajatam is a Brahma when you are looking at a Shukti. But you will still claim Pratyaksha Brahma. Samanadikaranam is there. Idam and Rajatam are in Samanadikaran, just like अहम मनुष्यः दिस इज इन सामानादिकरण इतिव सामानादिकरण्य प्रत्यक्षस्य भ्रमत्व शंका कलंकितस्य इट इज हाउएवर टेंटेड बाय द डाउट रिगार्डिंग भ्रम देयर इज अ भ्रम इज इट अ भ्रम और अ प्रम यू विल रिमेन इन डाउट इट हैज टू बी रिजॉल्व्ड बाय व्हाट अनलाइक द केस ऑफ शुक्ति यू कैन नॉट हैव अनदर प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण विच विल काउंटर इट. Meaning, Indriya Janya Pratyaksha Pramana cannot counter it. Therefore, there is a Shabda Pramana which can counter this knowledge, and that is Agama Pramana. So, na Agama Pravalyam iti Asteyam. there cannot be pratyaksha anubhava as to I am manushya, I am karta, etc., which is tainted by brahmatva shanka. Therefore, it cannot be more powerful a pramana and hold more weightage than the agama pramana, which says that you are akarta. ठीक है देहात्मवाद प्रसंगाल इत्यर्थ देहात्मवाद प्रसंगाल उभय वादी सिद्धस्य मनुष्योम इति सामानादिकरण्य प्रत्यक्षस्य यथा भ्रमत्वम तथा अहम कर्ता इत्यादि प्रत्यक्षस्य अपि भ्रमत्वम सो अहम कर्ता इज इक्वली इनवैलिडेटेड जस्ट लाइक अहम मनुष्य इज इनवैलिडेटेड नाउ दिस कर्तृत्व When you say tattvamasi, there you are akarta, that is what is being said. Purvapakshi is saying that I agree that I am not a manushya. There it can be brahma, but why would it be brahma in the case of I am akarta? So the darshanika says that, Sankhya says that atma is not a karta, but atma is a bhokta. Some say that atma is a karta. So now, If one is agreeing that I am not a manushya but I am a karta, there the same logic will hold good. So, same counter will hold good. Just like the case of manushyaham is a brahma because it is refuted by the shruti pramana. Similarly, aham karta is a brahma refuted by the shruti pramana. That is said here, yatha brahmatvam tatha. Just like manushyo aham is a brahma agreeable to both parties. Vedanti also and the Puru Pakshi, this Karta, Aham Karta should also be accepted as Brahma, Brahmatva Prasanga. So, it is said, Tatha Aham Karta Ityadi Pratyakshasya Abhi Brahmatvam Asteyam Iti Brahma Swarupatvena Siddhasya Adhyasasya Sakshi Pratyaksha Atmaka Bhana Sambhavad. This Adhyasa, Aham Karta, Aham Ajnaha, Aham Manushya, all three are equally Brahmas, refuted by the Shruti. Now, Brahma Swarupatvena Siddhasya Adhyasasya. I think earlier word has a typo, so I am reading it as Asteyam. Brahma Swarupatvena Siddhasya Adhyasasya Sakshi Pratyakshatmaka Bhara Sambhavad. Now, this Adhyasa is known not by the Pramata, because Pramata is part of the cognition there, who is himself deluded. So Sakshi is free from this prama, from this tripoti, and that Sakshi reveals that this vritti in the antakarna, where the Pramata himself considers included in the vritti, he considers himself as a karta, whereas shabda bodha taking place that I am a karta. That counters, and then sakshi pratyaksha it is that the earlier knowledge is a brahma. It is an adhyasa. So, brahma swarupatvena siddhasya adhyasasya sakshi pratyakshatmaka bhana sambhavat. Sakshi knows that this is, Sakshi reveals that this vritti is not pramatmaka, it is brahmatmaka. So it is not pramavishayaka jnana, it is brahmavishayaka jnana. Therefore, bhanam, this abhanam, the abhana that you are claiming, what abhana? Abhana of adhyasa. Once the Shruti reveals that this is not a fact, you are akarta is a fact, whereas you being karta is not a fact. And similarly, ajnaha and manushya you cannot be. Therefore, the knowledge that you have is a brahma, it is not a prama. And thereby you cannot any longer claim that you are not having anubhava, there is no bhana of adhyasa. So, abhanam ayuktam. Adhyasasya abhanam ayuktam. This is the second paksha which has been countered is bhavaha. Jnanatma pratyaksha nishtham jeshtatvam avikshatva pratyakshasya prabalya bhavaha sadhita. संप्रति ज्येष्ठत्वं योक्षित्वा प्रावल्याभावं साधयति किञ्चैति. अर्लियर सिद्धांति टुक द ऑप्शन ऑफ अभान एंड सेड दैट देयर इज नो ज्येष्ठत्वं इन प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण एज अपोज टू श्रुति. नाउ एक्सेप्ट एंड देन देयर बाय ही रिफ्यूटेड दैट देयर इज अध्यास भान. Now this the same second option is analyzed abhanadva adhyasasya abhanadva. Therefore the Puropakshi who is saying there is jeshta pramanatvam in pratyaksha, so prima facie agreeing with it. Okay, jeshta meaning what? There is a dependency. Jeshta pratyaksha pratyaksha pramana is jeshta compared to shruti. How so? Because shruti has a dependency on the श्रवण इंद्रिया फॉर शब्द बोध. फॉर शब्द बोध टू टेक प्लेस देयर शुड बी द शब्द शुड बी श्राव्य. सो इट हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन श्रवण इंद्रिय जन्य ज्ञान. पद ज्ञान हैज टू टेक प्लेस बिकॉज यू हैव टू हियर द पदास एंड यू हियर द पदास बाय प्रत्यक्ष. देयरफॉर प्रत्यक्ष इज द उपजीव्य प्रमाण ऑन विच श्रुति पदास विल बी हर्ड. Taking that option, the Siddhanti is countering now. So, it is said that Jnanatma Pratyakshanishtham Jyeshtatvam Avyakshitva. There the Jyeshtatvam is not agreeable, that is not the Vyaksha. Pratyakshasya Pravalya Bhava Sadhita. Pratyaksha has been shown as not being stronger to the Shruti Pramana. Now, Samprati, now what has been done? Jyeshtatvam Vivakshitva. Okay, let's assume that it is Jyeshta Pramana. And thereby, I'll show you how the Pratyaksha Pramana is not Pravalya compared to Shruti. So, Pravalya Abhavam Sadhayati Kinchayati. Ratna Prabha, Kincha Jyeshtatvam Purobhavitvam Bha Agama Jnanam Prati Upajivyatvam Bha. Now, Jyeshtatvam also. Jyeshtatvam means just, you know, it's a superior Pramana. It is more important or it is higher in the hierarchy of pramanas. If that is the question, why is it higher? Why is it superior? So there Siddhanti makes two options and asks, why do you think that Pratyaksha Pramana is Jyeshta? Is it because it came up earlier? Purobhavitvamva. It is prior, this Pratyaksha Jnana is prior to the Shruti Jnana. Aham Karta. Etc. This jnana is prior to aham akarta revealed by the shruti. So purobhavitvam. Or agama jnanam prati upajivyatvam. This is the option we have taken. But both options are created by the siddhanti. Considering that the agama jnana has dependency on the pratyaksha jnana, pratyaksha is jyeshta pramana. Is this the second option that you take? To consider Pratyaksha Pramana Jyeshta. Adye means if you take Purobhavitvam. Because Aham Karta Jnana precedes Aham Akarta Jnana, then Adye na Prabalyam. That does not make this Jyeshta Pramana Prabalya Pramana. Jyeshta Stomastu. Prabalyam tu Nasti. Why? Because in Rajju Sarpa or in Shukti Rajata also what happens? Prior you know the Rajju to be Sarpa. Then you have follow on Pramana which counters this. So earlier you have Sarpa Jnana, then you have Rajju Jnana. But still Rajju Jnana has Prabalyam. The Sarpa Jnana just by being the earlier Jnana does not have Prabalyam. Idam Rajatam. Then Iyam Shukti. Iyam Shukti is a later jnana which counters the earlier jnana as to Idam Rajatam. Therefore, there is no Prabalyam in the Idam Rajatam jnana. Similarly, here also, Adhyena Prabalyam Jyeshtasya Api Rajatam Pramasya Paschad Bhavina Shukti Jnana Bhadha Darshana. There is Bhadha of this is a silver knowledge, although it precedes the. This is not a silver But it is not a silver coin. What is it? It is a shell. That knowledge, Shukti Jnana, negates the silver Jnana, although the Shukti Jnana is later. Now, Dvitiya, now if you claim the Agama Jnana, Jnanam Prati Upajivyatvam, the Pratyaksha Pramana is Upajivya towards the Agama Jnana. Agama Jnana depends on this. So that will be counted before that Tika. Kinchaiti, Purvabhavitvam, Purvakalavrittitvam, Upajivyatvam, Hetutvam, Pratyakshasya Vyavaharika Pramatvena, Eva Upajivyata, Na Tatvika Pramatvena, Iti, Tatvika Pramatvamshasya Nehananasi Kinchanityadhyagamena, Bada Sambhavat, Na Tasya Prabalyamiti Dushayati. Na Dvitiyeti. If you pick the second option, Purvabhavitvam is what? Purvakalavrittitvam. Purvabhavitvam means it was there in the earlier kala. That understanding was there. This is the silver. What is Upajivyatvam? Upajivyatvam Hetutvam. That Hetu which is given Upajivyatvam, that is what? Pratyakshasya Vyavaharika Pramatvena Upajivyata. In the Vyavahara, Vyavaharika Jeshtatvam is there. Meaning, for all Vyavahara, Pratyaksha is a Jyeshta Pramana. We do agree. For Anumana, for other Pramanas, dealing with Vyavaharika Vishayas. For that, you need Pratyaksha Pramana and it is a Jyeshta Pramana. And being Jyeshta Pramana, what kind of Jyeshtatvam is there? It is Upajivyatvam. So, Upajivyatvam of Pratyaksha Pramana, which is Jyeshta Pramana, we also agree, but only in Vyavaharika Vishaya. So, Vyavaharika Pramatvena Upajivyata. So, Upajivyatvam is a Dharma. This Dharma itself is divided into two Dharmas now. Upajivyatvam. Upajivyasya Bhava Upajivyatvam. Upajivyatvam Kutra Vartate. Pratyaksha Pramane, Jyeshta Pratyaksha Pramane Vartate. Now, in Jyeshta Pratyaksha Pramane, there is Upajivyatvam. What kind of Upajivyatvam is there? Here, the Siddhanti creates two options and says that both can be there. Or one can be there. Now, we'll analyze this. So, he says this Vyavaharika Upajivyatvam is one possibility and Tatvika Upajivyatvam is another. Meaning, Vyavaharika Pramatvena Upajivyato. Related to Vyavaharika Vishaya or Tatvika Vishaya. Tatvika Vishaya is the reality, the truth. The final truth about Atma. So, Brahmatma Vishaye Upajivyato Nasti. Vyavaharika Vishaye Pratyakshasya Jeshta Pramanasya Upajivyato Masti. So, this Upajivyatvam or Upajivyata, these are split into two, Vyavaharika Pramatvena and Tatvika Pramatvena. So, this Upajivyatvam Hetutvam Pratyakshasya Vyavaharika Pramatvena Eva Upajivyata Asti Natu Tatvika Pramatvena Iti Tatvika Pramatvamshasya. That Dharma which is divided into two now as to Tatvika Pramatvamsha and Vyavaharika Pramatvamsha. This Tatvika Pramatvamsha is refuted. Jyeshta Pratyaksha Pramana does not have. So, Jyeshtatvam is Upajivyatvam. So, that Pratyaksha Pramana having Jyeshtatvam is equal to Upajivyatvam is equal to Vyavaharika Pramatvena Upajivyatvam. So, Vyavaharika Pramatva Upajivyatvam is accepted. But Tatvika Pramatva Amusha is not accepted. Why so? Nehananasi Kinchana Ityadhyagamena Bada Sambhavat. Because there is a Shruti which refutes this Tatvika Pramatva Amusha. In reality, you are Akarta, Amanushyaha and Jnana Swarupa. As to Indriyas being there, pramanas being there, multiple pramanas being there, which establish plurality of the samsara, etc. All these claims will be follow on because neha nana asti kinchana. This nanatvavada won't hold good. So there is no possibility of your pratyaksha pramana countering anything because your pratyaksha pramana sees yourself as a karta of a kriya which is separate from you, manushya, kriya which is separate from you, karma which is separate from you, all sorts of karakas which are separate from you. Therefore, you say I am a karta. So when you say karta, it means that I am not any of the other karakas, I am only the kartru karaka. In that activity at least. So when you say kartru karaka, I am, you are separating yourself from all the other karakas. Those are refuted by the Shruti by saying neha nanasti kinchana. If you say I am a manushya also, same problem. You are a manushya as opposed to other manushyas as well as other amanushyas. There also neha nanasti kinchana. There is no plurality at all in this Brahmatma. So your claim is falsified by the Shruti. So that Tattvika Pramatva Amsha is refuted by the Shruti. What is being done is that, yes, Shruti, Shabda that you are hearing related to the Tattvika Vishaya also, there the Shruti has dependency on the Pratyaksha Pramana, without which you will not hear the Neha Nanasti Kinchana. These Shabdas for the Vyavaharika Shabda. Now the Shabda is Vyavaharika. The Artha is not Vyavaharika anymore. The Shabdas are Na, Iha, Nana, Asti, Kinchana. When you hear them, these can be related to any Vishaya. So when you hear that, the Shruti does have dependency on the Shrotrendriya, which is a Pratyaksha Pramana for you, which will give you what Jnana? It can give you Pratyaksha Jnana. It can give you Shabda Jnana also. Now when you heard it, then this, the hearing of the word is by Pratyaksha Pramana. But the Vakya Artha that you understand, Shabda Bodha that takes place, that is called as Shabda Pramana. And the knowledge that takes place is called as Shabda Bodha. It's a Prama. Because it is from the Apta Vakya, Shruti Vakya is an Apta Vakya. Therefore, there is Shabda Bodha that takes place. Now that Shabda Bodha that takes place from the Shruti is related to Tatvika Vishaya. That time, on that Tatvika, the Tatvika Amsha does not have any dependency on what you heard. In the sense, the Indriyas have no play anymore. The Indriyas and the Shrotrendriya, which is a Pramana, that has no role to play in the interpretation of the Shruti Vakya. The Shabda Bodha takes place irrespective of the Indriya now. Irrespective of the Jyeshta Pratyaksha Pramana, it was Jyeshta so far as aiding the hearing of the sound. After you have heard the sound, the Tattvika Amsha is being dealt with. So far only Vyavaharika Amsha was being dealt with, which is what word you hear. Now the Tattvika Amsha which is being dealt with in the Shabda Bodha, that is also not Vyavaharika Amsha. And even if it is relating to Vyavaharika Visha also, the Shabda Bodha has nothing to do anymore with the Shravane, the Shrotrendriya. So Tattvika Amsha is refuted now. Tattvika Amsha is refuted and thereby the Jeshtatvam, meaning Upajivyatvam of the Pratyaksha Pramana is refuted, which establishes Karta, Manushya, etc. and thereby establishes Nanatvam. फाइनली यू विल हैव टू एग्री दैट व्हेन यू से आई एम कर्ता है मनुष्य देन नानात्व इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज सून एज यू क्लेम दी जीवत्व भाव शरीर शरीर भाव देन अदर शरीर आर ऑल्सो एस्टैब्लिश्ड along with that statement as soon as an individuality is claimed the plurality is also claimed they go hand in hand so when you are saying I am a karta I am karta then other karakas you have separated yourself from and you are validating other karakas presence of other karakas which are refuted by the shruti there the shrotrendriya pratyaksha pramana has no play okay therefore what neha nanasti kinchana iti agamena tatvika pramatvamushasya bada sambhavat na tasya prabalyam iti dusheti na dvitiya iti ratna prabhana dvitiyah agama jnanotpatto pratyakshadi moola vruddha vyavahare cha sangati graha dvara shabdopalabdhi dvara cha pratyakshadehe pratyakshadehe vyavaharika pramanyasya upajivyatvyapi तात्विक प्रामाण्यस्य अनपेक्षित्वात् अनपेक्षितत्वात् अनपेक्षित अंशस्य आगमेन बाध संभवात् इति सो दिस हैज ऑलरेडी बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द टीकाकार सो अनपेक्षित अंश एंड अपेक्षित अंश दीज आर द टू अंशस इन टीका दे आर क्लैरिफाइड एज अपेक्षित अंश इज द व्यावहारिक प्रमात्वेन उपजीव्यत उपजीव्य So which is accepted in the pramana pratyaksha pramana. So in the pratyaksha pramana, vyavaharika pramatvena upajivyata, meaning upajivya bhava, upajivyatvam is accepted in the pratyaksha pramana, and that is the apekshita amsha. Whereas anapekshita amsha means the प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण हैज नो लॉन्गर एनी प्ले इन दी तात्विक अंश सो दैट तात्विक अंश इज दी अनपेक्षित अंश इन दी केस ऑफ प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण सो यू कैन कंसीडर देम एज टू सेपरेट धर्मास वन इज एक्सेप्टेड द अदर इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेड सो अपेक्षित अंश इज दी व्यावहारिक प्रमात्वेन उपजीव्यता उपजीव्य अंश उपजीव्यत्व अंश एंड The anapekshita amsha is the tatvika pramatvena upajivyata or upajivyatva amsha. So agama jnana pattau, for the agama jnana to take place, what is needed? Pratyakshadi moola vruddha vyavaharecha. So in agama jnana and in pratyakshadi moola vruddha vyavahara, in both cases, संगति ग्रह द्वारा शब्दोपलब्धि द्वारा च प्रत्यक्षादेहे व्यावहारिक प्रामाण्यस्य उपजीव्यत्वे अपि सो दिस व्यावहारिक प्रामाण्यस्य उपजीव्यत्वम् इज देयर इन व्हिच केस इट इज देयर इन द केस ऑफ आगम ज्ञानोत्पत्ति आल्सो एंड प्रत्यक्षादि मूल वृद्ध व्यवहार आल्सो सो व्हाट इज दिस प्रत्यक्ष आगम ज्ञानोत्पत्ति वी सॉ इन द टीका What is pratyakshadi moola viruddha vyavahara? In which case we agree that there is a dependency and that's how a person gets knowledge. Now in pratyakshadi, in vyavahara, you have pratyakshadi moola viruddha vyavahara. So this will be explained in the tika. I'll just give you a background and then we'll go through tika faster. So how does a child learn? Now when you want to learn a new language, So you have basis. So let's say you want to learn Sanskritam or German or French or whatever have you. In which language do you want to learn? So you have to tell the teacher that I know English, I know Hindi, whatever. So based on that language, the other language is taught. So it is easier. But if you inquire into how did you learn your first language, your mother tongue, how did you learn it? So here the Sanskrit itself is taken as an example as a mother tongue. How does one understand the first language without knowing any language there it is mind boggling as in right now it is very easy for me to even try and learn any other language I can say well, it is difficult and all that, but at least there is a possibility of teaching because I know one language at least. Based on that, so you ask, you know, what does this mean? So in English, if something is said as pot, I know it as pot. In Sanskritam, it is called as ghata. So if the teacher explains this ghata ghata, I don't know what is ghata, then he says it means pot. So I understand that and I move on. I have no difficulty there. Or another way to learn is that he shows me a pot and says that this is called as ghata. Now in my mind, I know it is a pot. Oh, it is a pot. But in the first language learning, what happens is that this is the only way. You look at something, and then the words which are used in association with that vastu that you are looking at, that name and sanya sannibhava gets registered in the mind of the child. So here, how the child learns, that is shown is pratyakshadi moola vriddha vyavahare. So there is a vriddha. Vriddha means an elderly person, and there is a madhyama. So madhyama vriddha. So moola vriddha and then madhyama vriddha. So there is an elderly person who is also vriddha, but he is a moola vriddha. And there is a Madhyama Vriddha, maybe the elder brother of this child who is younger. He does not know the language, he is hearing and learning. So this child looks at his father telling his elder brother, you get a pot. Ghatamanaya, Gamanaya, all these, he hears these sentences over and over and over again. Gamnaya, Gamanaya, Ghatamanaya, Ghatamnaya. So based on these, and then he looks at, oh, gam anaya, he brings the cow. And then ghatam anaya, he brings the pot. So anaya also registers in his mind as bring, bring, bring. Naya, take away. Because the objects have changed, the word is the same in both cases, anaya or naya. And when ghata is replaced with gam or gam with ghata, ghatam, ghatam or then he knows the ghata also by looking at ghata is a pot. So whatever shape is there, this particular object is called as ghata. And this particular shape of the animal and these features of the animal, along with these features, this animal is called as the cow. Go. So this is how jnana takes place. This is an example given, and therefore the learning takes place. That time, pratyaksha pramana is upajivya. So, jeshtasya api, so not jeshtasya, agama jnanotpattau, as well as pratyakshadi moola vriddha vyavahare cha, sangati graha dvara, sangati shakti, pada has a shakti. So, shakti graha dvara, that pada has a shakti to reveal the padartha. As soon as the child hears it, and he looks at it, then he is able to associate. The shakti of the ghatapada is to reveal the ghata object. This is how the younger child also learns through that shakti, or what shabdopalabdhi dwaracha, and also through the shabdopalabdhi, shabdabodha. In both cases, प्रत्यक्षादेह व्यावहारिक प्रामाण्यस्य उपजीव्यत्वे अपि. इन बोथ केसेस वी डू एग्री दैट देयर इज अ डिपेंडेंसी ऑन प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण. इवन इन दैट केस तात्विक प्रामाण्यस्य अनपेक्षित्वा अनपेक्षितत्वा, बट देयर इज नो सच डिपेंडेंसी व्हेन यू आर डीलिंग विद तात्विक विषय. दैट हैज no dependency at all, because you are not going to look at the ghata. Just like you looked at the ghata, you are not looking at the atma. You are the atma. So in that case, there is no dependency on pratyaksha pramana. It is that which makes the indriya indriya. Shrotrasya api shrotram, says the Keno Upanishad. So there, your shrotra, श्रोत्रेन्द्रिया और अदर प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण विल नॉट बी द बेसिस it will not be the fundamental pramana on which shabda bodha will take place. For shabda hearing, all right, but not for shabda bodha. Then only shabda pramana will work. Meaning the padajnana put together, it will give you additional jnana. There is lakshana, etc. Therefore, shaktigraha is accepted only thus far. And thereby, pratyaksha is a jeshta pramana, upajivya pramana, only as long as the hearer does not hear the words. Once he hears the words, and since he knows the meaning of the word, till then, there is a dependency. After that, the tattvika, towards tattvika jnana, the pratyaksha indriya does not have, pratyaksha pramana does not have any role to play. And thereby, agamena, bada sambhavat iti. Therefore, this aham karta, this is a brahma which is countered by the agama, and therefore, being countered, it is badhita jnana, and therefore, it is not prama. Aham karta is a brahma, it is an adhyasa. And therefore, you cannot say adhyasasya abhanam. So, this is the background. Now, let's just quickly go through the tika. Agama jnana utpatto, what is the meaning of agama jnana utpatti? Agama rupa shabda vishayaka jnana janya akartru brahma vishayaka shabda bodho utpatto ityartaha. So, agama jnana utpatto means agama rupa shabda ha vishaya ha yasya jnanasya tadjnanam agama rupa shabda vishayakam jnanam. तादृश ज्ञान जन्य अकर्तृ ब्रह्म विषयक शब्द बोधः तादृश ज्ञानेन जन्यः यः बोधः व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बोध इज दैट जन्य अकर्तृ ब्रह्म विषयः अकर्ता मीनिंग अकर्ता अहम अकर्ता ब्रह्म विषयः यस्य शब्द बोधस्य सह शब्द बोध अकर्तृ ब्रह्म विषयक शब्द बोध. सो टू बहुरीज दे आर पुट टुगेदर इन दी समास एज आगम रूप शब्द विषयक ज्ञान जन्य अकर्तृ ब्रह्म विषयक शब्द बोध. सो आगम रूप शब्द विषयक ज्ञान जन्य इज इन कर्मधारा विद अकर्तृ ब्रह्म विषयक शब्द बोध. मीनिंग व्हाट अकर्ता अहम अकर्ता is a shabda bodha which takes place due to what? Due to a jnana. What jnana? That jnana which is agama rupa shabda vishaya. So that vishayaka meaning the agama rupa shabda vishaya. The shabdas are heard, which are those aham akarta. I am not akarta. Aham akarta brahma. So tattvamasi leads to a knowledge that I am akarta brahma. Aham akarta brahma. Now this aham akarta brahma is a shabda bodha. What was the shabda? Tattvam asi. Tattvam asi was the vakya. There are three shabdas were heard. Tattvam asi. We'll take an example case. So tattvam asi is agama rupa shabda. And jnana which is agama rupa shabda vishayaka. There you heard tattvam asi. There is a dependency on shrotrendriya which is a pratyaksha pramana. So, agam rupa shabda vishayaka jnana, it will lead to another jnana, which is shabda bodha. So, janya jnana is different from the pratyaksha jnana. Shabda you have heard, all right, but then the meaning of the shabda, meaning of the vakya complete, for that there is no dependency further on the shrotrendriya. So, that is the agam jnanotpatto in this earlier part there is a dependency, in the latter part there is no dependency. Pratyakshadi moolaha vakya prayogadi rupeda vruddha vyavaharena janyaha yaha sangati graha shakti jnanam. So graha is jnanam and sangati is shakti. So sangati graha means shakti jnanam. The shakti jnana which takes place for the child who is hearing the vakya being used by the father towards the elder brother, let's say. So, pratyakshadi moolaha vakya prayogadi rupeda vruddha vyavaharena janyaha यहा संगति ग्रह शक्ति ज्ञान सो देर इज सम ज्ञान बॉर्न इन द चाइल्ड व्हेन ही हियर्स द सेंटेंस बीइंग यूज्ड टू एड्रेस द एल्डर ब्रदर बाय द फादर तद्वारा या शब्दोपलब्धि तद्वारा च इत्यर्थ सो शब्द बोध टेक्स प्लेस फॉर द चाइल्ड ऑल्सो फॉर दैट देर इज प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण विच इज उपजीव्य तथा च उत्तम वृद्धा गा माने इति वाक्यं प्रयुंते तद्वाक्ये श्रोता मध्यम वृद्धा गवानयने प्रवर्तते ताम प्रवृत्तिं पश्यतः व्युत्पित्सुतो व्युत्पित्सो बालस बालस्य सो इस बाल हु इज पश्यतः हु इज सीइंग एंड ही इज अ व्युत्पित्सु देयर इज सम अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट टेक्स प्लेस इन द चाइल्ड हु इज लुकिंग एट व्हाट डज हिज एल्डर ब्रदर डू व्हेन द फादर सेज गामानय and then there is pratyaksha pramana involved all the way and then somehow he is able to connect there is a shakti graha and then through the shakti graha sangati graha shakti jnana the child is able to connect the words and sentences with the kriya and the objects being used or other karakas एंड देयर बाय तदा अस्य पदस्य अस्मिन् अर्थे शक्तिः इत्यादि शक्ति ग्रह जायते ओ दिस वर्ड मींस दैट दैट ऑब्जेक्ट सो दिस पदा एंड पदार्थ संबंध इज देयर दिस पदा मींस दैट पदार्थ दिस इज हाउ द चाइल्ड इज एबल टू कनेक्ट तेन अनंतरं पदार्थ ज्ञानादि द्वारा तस्य बालस्य शब्दबोधो भवति तस्मिन् शब्दबोधे शक्ति ज्ञानादि द्वारा श्रवण प्रत्यक्षादेः उपजीव्यत्वम् अस्ति इति भावः So in that Shabda Bodha that takes place, there is a dependency of the Bodha on the Pratyaksha, Shravana Pratyaksha, Prama, there is a dependency. Pramana and Prama also, there is a dependency all right. Because Vyavaharika Vishaya, he is looking at that Vishaya. So you can claim that there is a connection. There is a dependence, there is a connection and that connection has a dependency. That understanding of the connection has a dependency on the Pratyaksha Pramana. Therefore, Upajivyatvam is there and thereby Jyeshtatvam is there in Pratyaksha Pramana. Vyavaharikam yavad brahmajnanam na jayate tavad abaditam pramanyam pramatvam yasya pratyakshasita tasya ityartha. So, the samasas are explained Vyavaharika pramanyasya and Tatvika pramanyasya. So, what is Vyavaharika pramanyasya? व्यावहारिकम यावत् ब्रह्मज्ञानम् न जायते दैट इज व्यावहारिक ज्ञान व्हाट इज व्यावहारिक एज लॉन्ग एज द ब्रह्मज्ञान डज नॉट टेक प्लेस दैट टिल दैट टाइम ऑल द व्यावहारिक रिमेन्स अबाधित तावत् अबाधितम सो लॉन्ग द प्रपंच इज कंसीडर्ड एज रियल एंड वी डू एक्सेप्ट इट अंटिल ब्रह्मज्ञान डज नॉट टेक प्लेस घटपटादि प्रपंच अहंकारादि प्रपंच इज सत्य एज सून एज इट सत्य इन द सेंस व्हाट इज दैट सत्य नॉट ब्रह्मवत सत्य बट इट इज नॉट प्रातिभासिक वी डोंट से इट इज प्रातिभासिक सो वी गिव इट अ नेम एज व्यावहारिक एंड दिस व्यावहारिक इटसेल्फ इज अध्यास व्हाई बिकॉज इट कैन हैव बाधा बाय तत्वज्ञान Once there is Brahmajnana, then this Vyavaharika will be reduced to Pratibhasika. Till then, it will be called as Vyavaharika Pramanyam, meaning it will have Vyavaharika Pramanyam. So, Yavad Brahmajnanam na jayate, Vyavaharikam is what? Tavad Abaditam, it is not negated. Therefore, Pramanyam is there, meaning Pramatvam. Yasya Pratyakshasya, that Pratyaksha which has व्यावहारिक प्रामाण्यम बिकॉज इट इज नॉट निगेटेड सो फार बाय ब्रह्मज्ञान दैट काइंड ऑफ अ प्रत्यक्ष इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट इट इज कॉल्ड एज इन दी रत्न प्रभा एज व्हाट व्यावहारिक प्रामाण्य एंड तस्य व्यावहारिक प्रामाण्यस्य देन तात्विक प्रामाण्य इज ऑल्सो सिमिलर यू रिप्लेस व्यावहारिक बाय तात्विक सो व्हाट इज सेड देयर इन द टीका तात्विकम पारमार्थिकम related to paramartha brahma jnana so related to brahma vishaya atma vishaya aikya vishaya so tatvikam paramarthikam pramanyam pramatvam pramanyam means pramatvam instead of shani pratyaya to pratyaya yasya tat tat प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण एनी मोर In the interpretation and understanding, there is no expectancy of pratyaksha pramana at all after having heard the word. Only so far there is a dependency. Therefore, anapekshitatva meaning anupajivyatva ityartha. Pratyakshasya anupajivyatva nasti. Upajivyatva nasti anupajivyatva asti. There is no dependency on pratyaksha of this tatvika jnana nanu dharmi rupa pratyakshasya upajivyasya dharma bhedena anupajivyatve api agam badhitatvena upajivya virodha durvara ityashankayam dharmi nishede tavat agamasya tatparya bhavat dharmasya eva badha ityah now this is pratyaksha itself refuted by the shruti no pratyaksha is accepted pratyaksha pramana is there otherwise shruti jnana will also not work For Shruti Jnana to take place, Shrotrendriya should have Pratyaksha Pramanatvam. That is accepted. However, you cannot go further and use it for everything. You cannot say that for Tatvika Jnana also there is a dependency. It isn't there. So that is said as Dharma Nisheda is being done. Which Dharma Nisheda? Tatvika Upajivyatva Dharma is refuted in Pratyaksha. Is negated to be there. It is not accepted rather. Tatvika upajivyatva dharma is not accepted to be there in pratyaksha, but vyavaharika upajivyatva and all that shaktigraha etc. All for all that upajivyatva is accepted in pratyaksha. Meaning jeshtatva is accepted in those cases, not in tatvika. Now the पूर्व पक्षी से जो धर्म निषेधा इज बीइंग डन इवन इफ वन धर्म इज रिफ्यूटेड नॉट ऑल धर्मस सो ननु धर्मी रूप प्रत्यक्षस्य उपजीव्यस्य धर्म भेदेन अनुपजीव्यत्वे अपि इफ यू से धर्म भेद बाय धर्म भेद अनुपजीव्यत्व इज देयर बट धर्मी है उपजीव्य उपजीव्यत्व इज देयर इन प्रत्यक्ष देयरफॉर आगम बाधितत्वेन उपजीव्य विरोध दुर्वारा इत्याशंकायाम बट देन आगम बाधा इज बीइंग डन देन धर्मी इटसेल्फ इज काउंटर्ड नॉट सो देयर इज नो तात्पर्य देयर ओनली धर्म निषेधा देयर इज तात्पर्य इन सो धर्मी निषेधे तावद आगमस्य तात्पर्य भावात धर्मस्य एव बाधः ओनली वन धर्म इज काउंटर्ड यू कैन कैरी ऑन विद योर व्यवहार एंड क्लेम दैट देयर इज उपजीव्य उपजीव्यत्व इन प्रत्यक्ष वी डोंट हैव एनी इश्यूज वी एग्री विद इट वी ऑल्सो फॉलो दैट इज वाई द एंटायर संप्रदाय कंटिन्यूज विद व्यावहारिक सत्ता नॉट Calling it as Pratibhasika till Brahmajnana takes place. And even after Brahmajnana, we do give it Vyavaharika value. Jnani may have a Pratibhasika Vat Drishti in Vyavahara also. And he may not reveal it also. So that Loka Vyavahara continues. And therefore the Upajivyatva of Pratyaksha is also accepted in such cases. Iti aha anapishita aumshasya iti. What is this then? There is a tika there. Anavachedaka tatvika pramatva rupa dharmasya ityartha. So what is the anapekshita amsha there? Anavachedaka tatvika pramatva rupa dharmasya ityartha. So there is no acceptance of the tatvika pramatva in the pratyaksha. That dharma is not accepted. Agamena, what agama are you talking about there? Agamena bhada sambhavat. इति वाज़ द एंडिंग स्टेटमेंट इन रत्नप्रभा टीकाकार से आगम इज नेह नानासि किंचन इत्यागमेन इत्यर्थः द प्लुरालिटी इज रिफ्यूटेड देयरफॉर कर्तृत्वम इफ यू एक्सेप्ट देन कर्तृकारका विल ब्रिंग इन अदर कारकास आल्सो एंड देयरफॉर यू विल हैव एक्सेप्टेड नानात्वम व्हिच इज रिफ्यूटेड बाय द श्रुति व्यावहारिक प्रमात्वस्य अतिरिक्त वृत्तित्वे अपि उपजीव्यत्वावच्छेदकत्वम इतर निवर्तकत्व रूपम औपचारिकम इति भावः सो व्यावहारिक प्रमात्वस्य अतिरिक्त वृत्तित्वे अपि उपजीव्यत्वता अवच्छेदकत्वम इतर निवर्तकत्व रूपम औपचारिकम इति भाव सो आई स्किप दिस एनीवे we have got the overview there. I don't want to go into this sentence and analyze it further. This much understanding is sufficient for our purpose. Athava, other interpretation is athava, pratyaksha karanam vyavaharika pramatvam tu sahakari karanam. Otherwise, you can take the, we will not split it into vyavaharika and tatvika anshas. Even if you split it, we are not going to analyze it that way. Let's look at another way of analysis here is the Siddhanti Athava Pratyaksha Karanam. Pratyaksha Karana is there for Shabda Bodha. That cannot be refuted because for Shabda hearing also you need it. There Vyavaharika Pramatvam to Sahakari Karanam. So this is a Sahakari Karanam. It is not a main cause for Shabda Bodha also. Tathacha Tayor Agamena Badho Nasti. Then Agama is not refuting that. We agree with the Vyavaharika Pramatvam and Jetatva also you can hold on to up till the Brahmajnana. Until Brahmajnana. Tathacha Tayor Agamena Badho Nasti Kintu Tatvika Pramatva Badha Tatha Na Upajivya Virodha. So Upajivyatvam is accepted in one Ausha, other Ausha it is being refuted, that was said earlier. Now what has been said, Sahakari Karanatvam is accepted. And thereby Vyavaharikataya Sahakari Karanatvam. Tatvikatvam is not accept, is not needed also. Because you are just saying that Sahakari Karana, it is definitely helpful, we agree. But Upajivyatvam that you are claiming, that also can be there, but that will not override the Shruti. Therefore, what Tatvika Pramatva Badaha Kintu Tathacha Tayor Agamena Badho Nasti Kintu Tatvika Pramatva Badaha. So only Tatvikatvam is being refuted even when you say Sahakari Karanatvam, it is not a main Karana. Therefore, Tatvika Vishaya, there is no role of this Sahakari Karana and thereby Mukhyatvam isn't there and therefore what? Na Upajivya Virodha. So Upajivyatvam that you are claiming can be there. We agree that it can be there, but na prabaljam chaiti. However, it will not be strong enough to counter the shruti. Therefore, dushayati nadvitiyati. So, your second option also as to what nadvitiya meaning upajivyatvam va. Where jeshtatvam means upajivyatvam, that has also been countered. Upajivyatvam is not there, or even if upajivyatvam is there, still there is no prabaljam in the Pratyaksha Prama as compared to the Shruti. Pratyaksha Pramana as compared to the Shruti Pramana. Shashti Dvayam Pratyaksha Adher Na Visheshana Bahuri Rapi Purvat Nashrayaniya. So anyway, there is a analysis of Shashti Dvayam which is talked about here. Vyavaharika Pramanyasya and Tatvika Pramanyasya. So if you interpret as a Visheshana to Pratyaksha Adhe, being Shashti, these two also are Shashti, you take it as Visheshana to them. Then you interpret as Bahuri also, then also the analysis Purva na Ashrayana, Ashrayaniha is said here. So Pratyakshadi, so if you interpret Vyavaharika Pramanyasya Pratyakshadehe and then Tatvika Pramanyasya Pratyakshadehe, they become Visheshana. Now what is the further analysis if you look at it? Vyavaharikam Pramanyam Yasya Pratyakshadehe. Tat Pratyakshadi Vyavaharika Pramanyam and so on. The Bahuri is also not to be taken. We have seen that in the earlier analysis. Upajivyatvya Piti Pratyakshadi Nishta Vyavaharika Pramatvasya Sahakari Karanatva Satvya Piti Bhavaha. So Upajivya, you accept that is Upajivya even if it is so. Then what is the meaning? Pratyakshadi Nishta Vyavaharika Pramatvasya. This Vyavaharika Pramatvamsha is there in Pratyakshadi Pramana and that is what is the acceptance of Upajivyatva. Upajivyatva api means in Pratyakshadi Pramana. Pratyakshadi is Upajivya. How so? Pratyakshadi has Upajivyatva. Meaning what? Pratyakshadi has Vyavaharika Pramatvam. Sahakari Karanatva Satve api iti bhavaha. And what is that? That is Sahakari Karana. So Sahakari Karanatva, either you say Vyavaharika Pramatvam is there in Pratyakshadi and Sahakari Karanatvam is there in Pratyakshadi, but there is no Tatvika Pramatvam in Pratyakshadi or there is no prabalyam in pratyakshadi. So these dharmas are refuted considering the Nyayika's view of analysis. Okay, let's move on. Further, anapekshitatvad asahakaritatvad ityartha. Tarhi kasya pada ityataha. Then what is countered? Anapekshita is countered, meaning tatvika amsha is tatvika, tatvika pramatva amsha is countered. So we looked at all that. Asahakari dharmasya ityartha. The second interpretation, asahakari dharma. This tatvika amsha is not accepted there. Therefore, sahakari in only in hearing, but in interpretation further, that sahakari dharma is not going to prove anything. Therefore, asahakari dharmasya, the tatvika amsha is not there in pratyaksha pramana. Etar uktam bhavati. Finally, all this is confusing talk. So, what is the final meaning? There, tikakara very compassionately gives the final meaning, which itself may be a little tricky for us. उपजीव्ये वर्णपदवाक्यानां श्रावणप्रत्यक्षे वेदान्ति अभिमत व्यावहारिक प्रमात्व अंश एकः. सो दिस मच इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड मूव ऑन सेज द टीकाकार. उपजीव्ये वर्णपदवाक्यानां वर्ण दी वर्णज आर हर्ड अ वर्ण क ऑल दीज अक्षराज आर हर्ड व्यंजनाज एंड स्वराज आर हर्ड. Then pada is heard, vakya is heard. So you have a varna, pada and vakya. Then upajivya bhava is there on pratyaksha. So upajivya varna pada vakya nam shravana pratyakshe vedanti abhimata. Vedanti is except what? Vyavharika pramatva amsha. Eka, that is one amsha. Now the पूर्व पक्षी इज ब्रिंगिंग अनदर अंश. इसे जो तात्विक अंश इज ऑल्सो देयर वी डोंट एक्सेप्ट. देयरफॉर पूर्ववादी अभिमत पूर्ववाद्यभिमत पूर्ववाद्यभिमत मीन पूर्ववादी वादिना अभिमत बाय हिम व्हाट इज एक्सेप्टेड पूर्ववाद्यभिमत तात्विक प्रमात्व अंशश्च इति अंशद्वयम्. ही एक्सेप्ट जी व्यावहारिक एज वेल एज तात्विक. वी एक्सेप्ट ओनली व्यावहारिक अंश इन प्रत्यक्ष. सो अंशद्वयम् वर्तते. तत्र शाब्दबोधस्य उत्पत्त्यर्थं व्यावहारिक प्रमात्व अंशमेव अपेक्षते. फॉर शाब्दबोध व्हाट इज नीडेड व्यावहारिक अंश इज नीडेड. डू यू हियर द वर्ण? यस. हाउ डू यू हियर? बिकॉज प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण इज देयर. वी से वी एग्री. व्हाट अबाउट पद? वी एग्री. व्हाट अबाउट वाक्य? वी एग्री. नाउ ही सेज ओ देन इन द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ तात्विक ऑल्सो देयर इज डिपेंडेंसी. वी से वी डू नॉट एग्री. दैट्स ऑल द डिफरेंसेस आफ्टर ऑल दैट एनालिसिस. व्यावहारिक प्रमत्वांशम एव अपेक्षते यावत् ब्रह्मज्ञानम्. दैट टू टिल ब्रह्मज्ञान टेक्स प्लेस. आफ्टर दैट ऑल दीज फॉल डाउन लाइक अ कैसल ऑफ कार्ड्स. सो देयर ऑल दिस एनालिसिस इज आल्सो मीनिंगलेस. बट टिल देन व्हेन वी आर हैविंग अ डिबेट वी विल एग्री विद यू दैट व्यावहारिक अंश हैज अ डिपेंडेंसी ऑन प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण एंड ज्येष्ठत्व उपजीव्यत्व ऑल दैट इज वैलिड. But tatvika amsha is not accepted there. Yavad brahma jnanam na jayate tavad vyavaharika satyatvena pratyakshadi padarthanam sadbhava bhave sopatya sambhavat ataha na apekshita amsha eva agamena badhyate tatra eva shrutihe tatparyayati. So shruti has tatparya in refuting the tatvika amsha being there in the pratyaksha pramana. It is not going to prove you are being karta. Shruti will have prabalya. So that is the idea. Tatha cha pratyakshasya paramarthika swarupa badapeksha bhramatvam aham karta bhokta aham iti atma visheshyaka anatma nishthaka kartrutvadi dharmadhyasa rupam jnanam dharmi adhyasa mantara na sambhavati iti dharminor atmanatmanor adhyasa anubho siddha ityanodhyam. Finally, what is the conclusion? That aham karta ज्ञान इज प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध. अहम अकर्ता इज श्रुति सिद्ध. प्रत्यक्ष डज नॉट हैव प्राबल्यम कंपेयर्ड टू श्रुति. श्रुति सेज नेह नानासि किंचन तत्त्वमसि एंड देयरफॉर अकर्ता अभोक्ता आत्मा इज सिद्ध. एंड देयर बाय द अर्लियर ज्ञान विच वॉज देयर पूर्वभावी ज्ञान विच वॉज देयर अहम कर्ता विल बी रिप्लेस बाय अहम अकर्ता. सो अहम कर्ता विल स्टैंड बाधित. Being negated, it is not Prama, it is Brahma. It is Adhyastha. So therefore, Adhyasa is there. Vishaya is there. Shastra deals with this Vishaya. Therefore, Shastram Arambhaniyam. And what is the phala? Jnanadvara Dukkha Nivritti. Jnanadvara Kartrutva Bhoktrutva Nivritti. Jnanadvara Kartrutva Bhoktrutva Bhrama Nivritti. Tena Samsara Nivritti. Atyantika Dukkha Nivritti. Sukha Praptischa. And thereby Jnanadeva Kaivalyam. Jnanadeva Tu Kaivalyam. This is Siddha. Where there is Brahma, that will go only with Jnana, not by Karma Ityadi. And where there is no Brahma, Satya Jnana is there, Satya Vishaya is there, Satya Vastu is there, that will not go by Jnana. Purva Pakshi has said that Jnana Satya Bandhasya Nivritti Na Bhavati. Satya Bandha will not go by Jnana. Now we are saying that there is no Satya Bandha. Bandha is Adhyasa, which is proven now, and therefore Vishaya is there and it will go only by Jnana, and Shastra is this Jnana now. Dealing with that Jnana, it is analyzing all that. Now, Dharma is shown as Adhyasa, and earlier it was said that in the initial statement of the Adhyasa Vashya, it was shown that you cannot have Dharma Adhyasa without Dharmi Adhyasa. Now, Dharma Adhyasa being shown, since it is not possible without dharmi adhyasa is also there. Therefore, what? Dharmi adhyasa mantara, dharma adhyasa rupam, atma visheshaka, anatma nishtaka, anatma nishta, atma visheshaka, anatma nishta, kartrutvadi, dharma adhyasa rupam jnanam. This dharma adhyasa rupam jnanam, dharmi adhyasa mantara nasambhavati. Without dharmi adhyasa, it is not possible. Therefore, Dharmi Adhyasa is also there. Dharmi nor Anatma and Atma. Anatma Atmano Adhyasa. Anubhava Siddha iti Anavadyam. That is also Anubhava Siddha. This cannot be questioned at all by Purva Pakshi. We'll stop here. I didn't look at the clock. We'll look at more in the next part, starting with Yattu. So, this topic is over. The next topic comes up as to, if the bandha is satya, that can also go by Shruti. This is a claim of another Purva Pakshi, or another Purva Paksha at least, is what? Why do you need to have this jnana, aham karta, ityadi jnana, as adhyasa, as brahma? It can be satya jnana also. And satya jnana nivritti can also take place by Shruti. So this is an interesting topic that comes up. So adhyasa is countered by saying it is satya, but then Mukti won't be possible. This was the earlier Purva Pakshi. Now this Purva Pakshi says Mukti will be possible by Jnana. How? Because Shruti is Prabal Pramana, it will take away this Satya Anubhava also. So how that is countered, we look at in the next part. Yamiya Karmikam Gatopyari Sahodarapa Mahatpadam Yamiya Karmikam Sharanam Gatopyari सहोदराप महत्पदं तमाम आशुहरिं परमाश्री जनकजानकानंद सुखाकृति तत्सत् नमस्ते
नमस्ते